A very good morning, students. Our session of corporate finance. Now, in the previous session, we already discussed about the factors that determines the requirement for working capital, and then after we have seen the components of working capital. Now, in today's session, we are going to discuss about the sources of working capital. Means from where the company fulfill their requirement for working capital in the market. So here we are going to study the two different sources. Basically there are two sources, the external one and the internal one. So now let's discuss in detail the first one, that is shares and debentures. Yes, if the requirement for working capital is really very huge, and when the requirement is for the longest period of time. So now sometimes it has happened that company is not able to manage their working capital out of their routine profit, because the requirement is really very high and it is already there for the long period of time. So at that point of time, the company is going to issue the shares. They may issue equity shares or preference shares as per their conveniency, and then after they are going to issue debentures. So from these shares and debenture, the company is able to fulfill their requirement of working capital. Basically, MNCs or the large scale organization, they are going to raise shares and debentures for working capital, because when the size of the company is very huge, when the volume of the organization is very wide, so at that point of time, again the requirement for working capital is also very high. So large scale organization or any MNC, they are going to use this source, that is shares and debentures, for the fulfillment of requirement for working capital. So the first one is shares and debentures. Then after, retained earning. Yes, retained earning, or we can say that plowing back of profit. When the company is using their own profit in the organization, that is known as retained earning. Here company is using their proportions of profit in their own organization. So on the basis of that, the company is not going to approach for any extra need, or they are not going to approach for any external factors for the satisfaction of requirement for working capital. So when the company is using their own source, that is the net profit, so that is known, that is the one of the best source, because in retained earning, company is not going to pay any interest to anyone. So the cost involved in retained earning is zero, and company easily enjoy their own profit in their own way. So the second source is retained earning. Then after, commercial bank. Yes, banks or bank is, they are really very important source of working capital for any organization. Here bank is available for the fulfillment of requirement for working capital to any organization, whether they are tiny, whether they are small scale, whether they are medium scale or they are large scale. Basically bank provides the short term fund, or they are provide the current finance to the organization by way of loan or by way of cash credit. So when the bank is providing CC or short term loan, so the organization can easily satisfy their need for working capital. Then after fourth one, that is trade creditors. Yes, when creditors allows to sell their goods on credit to us, so it is again a kind of source of working capital, because here you are not going to pay anything. When you are going to purchase any raw material or any equipments on credit, and generally the credit limit is for 3 to 9 months, that is depends upon the organization's need and that depends upon the credit worthiness of the company. If the company's credit worthiness is very high, so creditors may allow a long-term credit to the enterprise, so the company may enjoy the credit for the longest period of time. So trade creditor is one of the major external factor that is going to be fulfilled the requirement for working capital. The next one is public deposits. When the requirement for working capital is really very huge, and when the other sources are not going to satisfy your current requirement, your current need, at that time company may issue deposits to the general public like shares and debentures. But it is a deposit, it is non-negotiable instruments, it is not marketable instruments. Means in public deposit you are not going to transfer your deposits to anyone, or you are not going to sell your deposit to any other person. So the public deposit is one of the source of working capital when the requirement is really very high, and the generally the time period of public deposits is minimum 6 months to maximum 3 years, and the rate of interest in public deposit is really very attractive because it is a risky capital, it is a risky deposit, because at the time of maturity no guarantee is given to the investors that your money will be back with a proper period of time. Then after sixth one is indigenous bankers and money lenders. Indigenous bankers and money lenders, they are the part of unorganized sector of our Indian financial market. The main task of indigenous bankers and money lenders, that is to provide very short-term finance to the business unit. They provide finance for days, yes, or for week or for a month. So here when the requirement is only for a shortest period of time, that is for 1 or 2 days, 1 or 2 weeks, or hardly 1 month. At that time, company is going to approach this kind of indigenous bankers or money lenders for their financial need. But basically, the rate of interest is very high because they are working in unorganized sector. So no rules, no regulations are going to be applied for them. And the last one is urban cooperative banks. Urban cooperative banks are those banks who provide the finance or who provide the loan to their member only. And generally, the main target for the establishment of this urban cooperative bank is to give the banking services in the urban area when the other services are not generally possible. So these are the main sources of working capital. Here, company is going to choose the source as per their requirement, as per their size, as per the availability of finance in the market. Now let's discuss the another point, the main point of working capital, that is characteristic of working capital. Here there are few features or characteristic of working capital. The first one is short-term needs. Yes, working capital is there for the satisfaction of short-term financial need of the organization. And the duration of working capital, that short-term financial need is totally depends upon the length of production process or the time that your product is, your raw material is converted into finished goods. So when the production process is very lengthy, so at that time the requirement for working capital is also for the long period of time. And when the production process is very smooth or when it is very fast, so definitely the requirement is very low. Then after, second one, that is circular movement. Yes, the working capital is circulating in a proper manner. So it is converting its own features into the different feature. So working capital constantly converting into cash against which the sources are there. So first, if we are purchasing raw material, then your cash is converted into raw material. Then after, when you are going to put your raw material in the production process, then your raw material is immediately converted into finished goods. And when you are going to sell your finished good, then definitely your finished good is converted into cash or credit. So the nature of working capital is on the conversion basis. It is converting its own feature in the routine in a regular manner. Then after, the third point is an element of permanency. Yes, working capital is for the short period of time, but it requires forever and always. Whatever the level of your production, whatever the size of your organization, the requirement for working capital is always there in your business organization, and this requirement is forever. Whatever stages your organization is facing in the business cycle, whether you are in the introduction stage or in the growing stage or in the maturity stage, the requirement for working capital is always there. If the working capital is not there, suppose imagine your business, imagine your organization without the working capital, then the question of sustainability will be there. If the company is not able to manage their basic requirement of working capital, then the company is not able to run in a long period of time. So the requirement, the amount may vary from time to time, from duration to duration, but there is always a requirement for working capital is there. Then after, element of fluctuation. Yes, there is no permanent amount of working capital is there. The requirement is permanent, but the amount is totally fluctuating. If the demand is low in the market, then the requirement for working capital is also going to be changed. When the production cycle is running in a proper manner, when the cash inflow and cash outflow is going to match with each other, then again the amount which is required for working capital is totally different. Then after, fifth one, that is liquidity. Yes, working capital is highly liquid in the nature. Means the elements of working capital can be easily converted into the marketable securities, or they can easily converted into cash. So we can say that the working capital is more liquid as compared to the fixed capital. If a company is in a need of cash, then the company can get it through the conversion of its working capital by insisting on quick recovery of its bills receivable or by sales of its stock. So, working capital is highly liquid in the nature. Then after, less risky. The risk associated with working capital is very low because it is for the shortest period of time. The amount involved in the working capital, the cash involved in working capital is very low as compared to the fixed capital. So the amount of or the level of risk is very low in working capital. Then after the last point, that is no need of special accounting treatment or special accounting treatment not needed. Yes, in working capital may we are going to include our current asset, that is the debtors are there, bills receivable is there, cash on hand is there, and cash at bank is there. So these are the routine course of accounting action. So in this point of time, no special accounting treatment is required. The accounting treatment for working capital is on the routine basis, on the common basis. So it's all about the characteristic of working capital. I hope you all are clear about these two points, that is sources and characteristic of working capital. Thank you, students. Thank you so much.